your genome. No, not a gnome, genome. It's your body's instruction manual, how to make you, run you, repair you. It's made of DNA. And it's written in code, 3 billion letters of it. And you inherit it from your mum and dad, and there's a copy of it in almost every cell of your body. Your code, everyone's code, is full of glitches, but they're what makes you you, unique. Some glitches are not so welcome, like being more likely to get certain types of cancer. These nasty glitches can run in families, but luckily that's rare. We've got lots of these glitches figured out. We know which page they're on. But it's a different story for most cancers. The cancer starts in just one ordinary, healthy cell with a change in just one genome. It can happen anytime, but the chances increase as we get older. Then other changes creep in, then more, and then it's a cancer cell. Soon there are more changed cells just like it. These changes in its code help cancer hide away, and they help it grow and spread. But they're also clues. What it might do next, what its vulnerabilities might be, what medicines might stop it in its tracks, even how it began. So how can the 100,000 Genomes Project help? We ask for a sample of healthy cells, usually taken from a little bit of your blood. We also ask for a tiny piece of the cancer, usually from tests originally used to diagnose you. Scientists take the DNA from the samples. They read out every one of those 3 billion code letters. Then they compare them. Cancer genome, healthy genome. They see what changes the cancer has made. Sometimes knowing the changes is helpful. It will help decide which treatment will work best for you. But sometimes what we see is confusing. We don't know enough. We need to know how to crack cancer's codes better. That's why if our scientists can't immediately find anything helpful, they put your genome codes, information about your cancer, and how things turned out for you into the 100,000 Genomes Project giant, super secure dataset. There are hundreds of people just like you in our dataset. The strength in numbers. Scientists can spot patterns which may reveal the clues we need to help more people like you in the future. Doing what we're trying to do is really difficult. And although we're getting faster all the time, it's still taking us longer than we'd like to get results back. Meanwhile, you need to start treatment quickly. This means the 100,000 Genomes Project might not be able to help you personally, although you'll still get the best care possible. People with cancer need this kind of information so they can be given the treatment that will work best for them. So right now, scientists need each one of us to help make it possible. If you take part, you're creating a legacy for generations to come. So if you decide to join the 100,000 Genomes Project, can we thank you on behalf of all those people like you that you'll help in the future?